Welcome, everyone, to our Remembrance Sunday service at Ulverston Parish Church, organised by Churches Together in Ulverston. A very warm welcome to you all. If I may say something on a personal note, this is the first Remembrance Day for some time not attended somewhere or other by my father, Peter Bing, who died this July at the age of 94. Dad joined the Royal Navy in 1943 at the age of 18, and he served in the Atlantic Fleet protecting shipping. He was involved in the relief of Norway and then in the Far East towards the end of the war. No doubt you will have particular people in mind today at Remembrance Sunday. They might have served in the armed forces, as my father Peter Bing did. They may have been serving their country in a civilian role, maybe waiting at home for those who served away. And they may be those who've been involved recently in combating COVID and putting the lives of others before their own. For those of us in church, the words will be on the screen. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From whence does my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. We meet in the presence of God. We commit ourselves to work in penitence and faith for reconciliation between the nations, that all people may together live in freedom, justice, and peace. We pray for all who in bereavement, disability, and pain continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. And we remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives in world wars and conflicts past and present have been given and taken away. So as we come before God together, we're going to have a moment of confession where we bring our sins to God and ask for his forgiveness. So together we say, Lord God, we have sinned against you. We have done evil in your sight. We are sorry and repent. Have mercy on us according to your love. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sin. Renew a right spirit within us and restore us to the joy of your salvation. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now we have a hymn which reminds us that God is with us now and in time to come. O God, our help in ages past. Thank you. have two Bible readings. First of all, from Ruth Hutchings, the youth minister for Ulverston and Furness, and then from Tina Boyle, guide leader. Thank you.
The first reading is from 2 Corinthians 10, verses 1 to 5. By the humility and gentleness of Christ, I appeal to you, I, Paul, who am timid when face to face with you, but bold toward you when away. I beg you that when I come, I may not have to be as bold as I expect to be towards some people who think that we live by the standards of this world. For though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God. We take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you, so that you might go and bear fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Thank you very much. And our preacher today is Darren Roy, the pastor of Emmanuel Community Church and also one of the volunteers at the local Air Cadets.
In the previous scripture reading today from John 15, we heard that greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for one's friends. When we consider the sacrifice that people have paid through the centuries in conflict, past and even present, there's an overwhelming sense of responsibility that we should make the most of the opportunity that's been given to us, an opportunity to live in freedom and to make the most of that freedom. For me as a Christian, to make the most of that freedom for Jesus Christ's sake. But in many ways, all of us have a responsibility to make the most of the life that's been given to us. Today we consider that people went before us and that none of us got here by ourselves. That there were people through generations and a story woven through humanity that got us to this place to where we are today. When we consider all the things that people have been through and all the sacrifices made, then again we come back to that overwhelming sense of responsibility. That sense that we're here for a purpose, we're here to make a difference. That sense that we don't want anyone to have paid a price in vain. If we have been shown the love that we have by people laying down their lives, and that's not just actually laying down their lives by dying, but also laying down their time, energy and efforts, and laying down family relationships and other relationships, the things that people have done through conflict and because of conflict and the things that people have been through that got us to where we are today, there is a sense of responsibility. It's not just a sense of responsibility, I believe, that we owe to soldiers, sailors, airmen and airwomen, servicemen and women. It's not just the responsibility we have to them. It's also in this 2020th year since Jesus Christ was on the earth. It's also the people who have been fighting a very different enemy, an enemy that's invisible, an enemy of disease. We think about the NHS staff and the carers and the volunteers and the charities and the churches and just ordinary people all paying a price that we could live in relative freedom, or at least have the opportunity soon to live in great freedom. And in the freedoms we have right now, I believe because of the things those people have been through, there is a responsibility on us to make the most of the opportunity. In the second reading from Corinthians, the Apostle Paul says that we're not fighting like flesh and blood or like human beings. The warfare of our Christian walk is a spiritual battle. And when we look around and the things that are happening to the world, we see the conflict and the hardship and the difficulty and the division throughout the world. And we see the pain that human beings inflict on each other and the things they're going through. We as Christian people have a responsibility to act differently and to fight a very different fight, to fight a fight that includes God and the virtues of God and the goodness of God, a fight that brings life to people and love to people and peace to people, a fight that shows people who our God really is. We have a responsibility. Sometimes at this time of year, I wonder what it would be like if I ever was face to face with people from generations past who had laid down their lives for me. Would my life be worth it? Would my life make a difference? Was the price they paid worth the life that I'm living? When I look at the things that I'm doing, am I making an impact? Yes, for Jesus' sake, but also an impact in people's lives with love and peace and joy that I bring to them, if indeed I do. Am I making a difference? Could I look those people in the eye that have paid a price? And could I feel comfortable with the life that I'm living? Well, in some ways this year that becomes a reality, because the people who are fighting the disease, the hidden disease, they're all around us. They're ordinary people, they're carers, they're our friends. There are doctors and nurses that we know. And those people are walking past in the street. And in some ways we can only see their eyes when they have a mask, but we see them and we have a responsibility to live like good people, God's people, to live lives that have God's fruit in them. That was in the previous scripture too. To have lives full of fruit, full of the fruits of God. So in a sense today, when we're thinking about those people that have laid down their lives and people that have been through things and done things for our sake, when we think of servicemen and women and all the things that they have done and all their lives, that all parts of their lives that they put on hold, and many paying the ultimate price, when we think of that, are we making the most of our life? Are we making the most of the opportunity and the freedom that we've been given? I would encourage everyone to be people of God's love, to be people of God's peace, to be people of God's joy, bringing hope and healing and light and life to people's lives. To bring healing where there is pain and to bring unity where there's division. To be people who say, I'm going to stand up and recognize what's been done for me. That I'm standing on the shoulders of giants and people who went before, and I'm going to make the most of it. Most of all, as a Christian, I want us to make the most of the ultimate price that Jesus paid, that he laid down his life for us. And in this freedom and in the freedoms we have, we should make the most of the opportunity to know him, to get to know him, to develop a relationship with him. That's my Christian belief. And as we get to know him, more and more of his fruits permeate our lives and more of his character becomes our character. And as we get to know him, the world starts to see Jesus in us. And our God, Jesus, is love. So my encouragement to you today, as we remember what people have been through And maybe we shed a tear as we remember those that have gone before that we knew, or we hear stories of real heroism and sacrifice. But in the midst of it, let's be people of responsibility, people who say, I'm going to make the most of the opportunity that those people afforded me. I'm going to make the most of this life for Jesus' sake. I'm going to show the world what love looks like. I want to be part of the healing process, not the division. I want to grow fruit, fruit worthy of God. Amen. So in the next hymn, let God move through us. Let's be channels of his peace. Let people see him in us. God, make me a channel of your peace, that I can bring your peace to this hurting world.
And now we have a familiar hymn, inviting God to make us channels of his peace. Make me a channel of your peace. And now Graham Ransom, who's the Methodist minister of Ulverston, will bring our Remembrance Day prayers. Thank you, Graham.
Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict, and ask that God may give us peace. For the servicemen and women who've died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known by God. May God give peace. God give peace. For those who love them in death as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss. May God give peace. God give peace. For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. May God give peace. God give peace. For civilians whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatreds of humanity. May God give peace. God give peace. For peacemakers and peacekeepers, those who work in the health service and emergency services, other key workers and all those who seek to keep this world secure and free. May God give peace. God give peace. For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. May God give peace. God give peace. O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish, and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world, and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
And now the Ulverston Town Band are going to lead us in an act of remembrance. So wherever you are, if you're able, I would invite you to stand with me.
Thank you.
Mervyn Bedford, the pastor of Croftland's Community Church and chair of Churches Together in Ulverston, will lead our Remembrance Day responses.
Let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace? We will. Will you seek to heal the wounds of war? We will. Will you work for a just future for all humanity? We will. Merciful God, we offer to you the fears in us that have not yet been cast out by love. May we accept the hope you have placed in the hearts of all people and live lives of justice, courage, and mercy through Jesus Christ, our risen Redeemer. Amen. Let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
And now the Ulverston Town Band will lead us in the national anthem, and again I invite you to stand if you are able. Thank you. And now Maddie Simpson, the curate of Ulverston, will give us the blessing.
God, grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the church, the Queen, the Commonwealth and all people, unity, peace and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son and Holy Spirit be with you all and remain with you always. Amen.